Is there anything that scientists have been hiding from us? The public's suspicion over NASA's concealing information is growing. Everyone is thinking about it, from astronomers and scientists to reporters and regular folks. Because of the heightened interest in space that has developed over the course of the past few decades, it is now absolutely necessary for space agencies to set up permanent space stations in space to assist with the continuation of research projects and plans. Researchers are still trying to get a better grasp of the variety of strange and mysterious occurrences that come along with attempting to understand a brave new frontier. This is something that is a natural part of the process. The International Space Station is equipped with 4 high-definition cameras, and the website of the National Aeronautics and Space Administration features live cameras that allow users to monitor events occurring in space above the surface of the Earth. People have reported noticing some additional things while participating in some of these. It is essential to take into account the fact that NASA and other space agencies have confirmed the veracity of these claims. Those who watched the video, on the other hand, were mystified because whatever can be seen in the footage appears to be very large. Users on multiple platforms were baffled after the video was uploaded to the internet and shared with others. Whatever it is, it appears to be flying in tandem with a number of other objects. The following was stated by one individual. On the International Space Station, I saw something very similar, but I was unable to take a picture of it. It's been some time since this happened, but I'm really glad I found this video because it validates what I've been relaying to other people about what I witnessed. This thing reminds me of a huge ship when I look at it. The sighting of unidentified flying objects in the vicinity of the International Space Station is not something that is new to me. Another one of these appeared to me some time ago, and it was a massive disc made of silver. Another user made the following comment just before the screen went black. This video is intriguing for a number of reasons, the most obvious being that it appears that a massive ship is heading toward Earth. However, shortly after this, the camera changes, and we are no longer able to see what is going on. This is one of the many reasons why this video is interesting. When a mysterious object appears on the ISS camera, the camera immediately switches to another camera, preventing us from seeing more of the object. Doesn't this seem like a bit of a coincidence? Some people have suggested that it is so glaringly obvious that NASA is aware of something going on, despite the fact that the space agency continues to refute a variety of theories concerning the possibility of UFOs and other objects in the area surrounding the ISS. The most famous examples originate directly from that continuously broadcast live footage of the International Space Station. In recent times, there have been a number of instances in which footage of strange objects floating in the distance has been captured, leading many people to believe that the origin of the footage is extraterrestrial. After such occurrences have been identified, NASA either removes or edits the video footage, cuts the live feed, or chooses to ignore the entire incident entirely. When asked about the incident, NASA frequently responds that the video footage was edited to create the illusion of a presence of extraterrestrial life. In point of fact, the BBC has demonstrated on multiple occasions that live footage from NASA was derived from older footage that was played in 2015. Because of this, many people all over the world now believe that there is apparently direct evidence of efforts being made to conceal proof that extraterrestrial life exists. In addition to this, it appears to be direct evidence that certain communities are utilizing to prove that something is occurring. People are curious about a recent discovery that was made close to Antarctica because they do not know what it is or how long it has been there. Many people are perplexed by the presence of 4 large pyramids in the area close to Antarctica because they believe the pyramids have no business being there. People are applying the same theory to these mysterious structures, saying that they don't look like mountains or anything natural, and that you can see that they look like they've been placed in a straight line. This is one of the reasons why the theory is being applied. When the images were shared with online communities that researched ancient buildings and artifacts, the members of those communities had a difficult time understanding what had been discovered. One person was quoted as saying the following: "Some of the underwater pyramids that have been presented in the past don't look anything like pyramids, and instead look like natural underwater features that are in the shape of a pyramid. The fact that, when viewed from above, this image appears to resemble the pyramids that can be found in Egypt is certainly an intriguing discovery. This does not imply that something from another world was responsible for their creation. However, it does raise the possibility that there is a long-lost civilization in the area, which is already an extremely intriguing prospect. Another person provided the following feedback. We need to base our decisions on the facts, not just the statements. This is a valid point of view, given that numerous scientists have been shown to be incorrect in the past. As a result of this, it should not come as a surprise that there are numerous tales about actual encounters with ancient creatures that have been passed down through the ages and into modern times. It has been demonstrated by the existence of the coelacanth that scientists are not infallible, and the same is true with regard to the existence of these kinds of structures unless we have personally investigated them. The marine engineer and her husband are the sole proprietors of a company known as Advanced Digital Communications, which is located in Canada. Off the coast of Cuba, they were participating in a survey mission that was organized in conjunction with the Cuban government. The administration of Fidel Castro was one of the four companies that worked in conjunction with the government of Cuba to explore the waters off the coast of Cuba. The search for treasure shipwrecks from the time period of Spanish colonial rule was their primary interest. When the team was scanning the area with some extremely cutting-edge technology, that's when they came across these peculiar structures. A few of these structures were discovered to be made up of smooth blocks and various geometric shapes. Others were entirely cyclical in nature. After some time had passed, they went back to the location with another geologist, this time with the knowledge that they already knew what they would find there. They went back with the necessary equipment to investigate and document the structures. The large blocks look like they are made of granite. The primary component of this is so difficult to understand that it would have taken approximately 50,000 years for structures like these to have descended into the ocean. The catch is that there was no architectural capacity in any of the cultures that existed at that time, which means that they would not have been able to construct such complicated things even if they had attempted to do so 50,000 years ago. This story was quickly buried in the sites left unresearched, despite the fact that there was such a media frenzy surrounding it. This has led some people to question whether or not there was a suppression of information regarding the discovery, whether or not the leads were cold, or whether or not this is related to something else. Of course, there are those who believe this to be a prime example of scientists choosing to ignore their data in favor of supporting a particular theory rather than conducting actual research. According to the Ocean Service, there is still over 80% of our oceans have not been explored as of 2018. Even though many people believe that outer space is one of the last unexplored frontiers, one could also argue that the oceans around our planet belong on that list. After all, we have done an excellent job of mapping inaccessible regions of our planet, but we have not yet been successful in conducting research in some areas of our oceans. So what are your thoughts? Do let us know in the comment section below. And that brings us to the end of the video. Feel free to let us know what you think about this video. And if you like this video, then please leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing content.